musicians are as close to God as man can be. We hear his voice. We read his lips.
The year is 1824 Vienna, and Ludwig van Beethoven is poised to perform his famous Ninth Symphony, but parts aren't ready, so he hires an aspiring composer to help him copy his work, thus the title of the film, Copying Beethoven. Ed Harris portrays the celebrated composer and clears up the question of whether or not he actually copied Beethoven for the role.
Yeah, the title is a little misleading because it's not about copying, me copying Beethoven. It's about a copyist who comes in to copy his notoriously illegible manuscripts. I just got to work on it, man, and I just started doing all I could, you know. Practice playing the piano hours a day and taking conducting lessons, you know, and listening to all of his music that I was not, I was familiar with some of it, but certainly not to the extent that I am now, and wasn't even aware of a lot of it. So it was just a total education.
Music wasn't the only thing Ed discovered about Beethoven. He describes how he educated himself about the composer's mythic status amongst his peers and his public.
There's so many books have been written about him, different aspects of him, his letters, the books of his letters and letters written to him, and people talking about him that knew him at the time, looking at the paintings of him and the different images, some really great kind of cool sketches of him walking through the town and his kind of eccentric kind of way, you know. So it was all just, you know, I spent 9-10 months prior to filming of just trying to immerse myself in everything I could about him. And then you have to channel all that, trying to play a human being.
Harris comes from a musical background, so he had some experience reading notes, but looking like Beethoven was more of a challenge. He packed on the pounds, wore special wigs, and even covered his baby blues with brown contact lenses.
Well, Beethoven didn't have blue eyes, man, you know, so I don't think it would have worked. So it was fine. I mean, you know, they were... The contacts were fairly comfortable. I forgot I had them on, you know, once I got used to wearing them.
In the film, Harris wears a metal contraption strapped around his head, which helps funnel sound to his ears as Beethoven was going deaf. He also wore plugs in his ears to muffle his own hearing. Copying Beethoven opens today in theaters.